Hi friends, welcome back to Joe Edukir.
In this video, I have explained about efficiency of a transformer. Let's get into the video. Under this topic, we are going to discuss what is the efficiency of a transformer. First of all, we will write down the definition for efficiency of a transformer. Efficiency of any device is defined as the ratio of the power output to the power input. So for the transformer, I'll write on the efficiency formula. The efficiency of a transformer is defined with an variable neta. So according to the definition, I'll write down the formula for efficiency of a transformer. So according to the definition, it is the ratio of the power output to the power input. I'll write down what is output power. The formula for output power is given as, so you know that V2 and V1 are the output and input voltage respectively. I2 and I1 are the current flowing through the secondary and primary winding respectively. And cos phi are the power factor of secondary and primary winding respectively. So this is about efficiency of a transformer. So next there is a derivation to find out the condition for maximum efficiency. We have seen what is efficiency of a transformer. So we'll write down the formula for efficiency. So according to the definition, efficiency is equal to output power divided by input power. So this is the base formula to derive a condition for maximum efficiency. Before going to the next step, what you're going to do is, we know that input is not always equal to output because there will be losses in any kind. So input is not equal to output always. It is output plus losses. So now if I want to write it for power, I will rearrange this equation for output power. So now output power, when I rearrange, I'll get output power is equal to input power minus losses. So I'll get an equation for output power in terms of input power and losses. So this I will substitute in the efficiency formula. So now neta is equal to output power is nothing but input power minus losses in the numerator divided by denominator. I will just write down input power as it is. Now we know that input power nothing but V1 I1 cos phi 1. I substitute this in the efficiency formula. So neta is equal to input power when I substitute V1 I1 cos phi 1 minus divide by in the denominator a same thing input power I need to substitute. So V1 I1 cos phi 1. Here losses. What are the losses in the transformer which we have discussed earlier? So we know the total losses in a transformer are iron loss plus copper loss. So I'll represent Wi as iron loss and this as copper loss. So total losses are nothing but iron loss plus copper loss. We'll multiply negative sign inside the bracket. So when I multiply negative sign inside the bracket, if I simplify this equation, I'll get V1 I1 cos phi 1 minus iron loss minus copper loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1. Now I'll split the numerators. So I'll get neta is equal to V1 I1 cos phi 1 divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1 as one term minus iron loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1 as denominator minus copper loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1. Now I'll simplify this. The first term gets cancelled with the numerator. So when I simplify this, this will be 1. So 1 minus, what is copper loss? We know copper loss formula which we have written. Copper loss is equal to I1 square R01. It is also equal to I2 square R02. So under the losses topic, we have discussed about this. Now here I will consider this as copper loss, I1 square R01. So in the place of copper loss, I will substitute this formula, I1 square R01. So I will get iron loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1 minus, after substituting copper loss, I will get I1 square R01 divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1. Now when I simplify this, so 1 I1 gets cancelled. So I'll get 1 minus iron loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1 remains as it is minus here I1 R01 divided by V1 in denominator into cos phi 1. I will take this as equation number 1. Here my target is to find out condition for maximum efficiency. Now till now we have found out for efficiency. We got efficiency as after simplification we got some equation. This is just an efficiency. I need to find out condition for maximum efficiency. So before finding the condition, first I will find out maximum efficiency. To find out maximum efficiency, this is efficiency formula. So efficiency is maximum when the condition is this. When you differentiate efficiency neta with respect to I1 and you have to equate it to 0, so this is when efficiency will be maximum. Now we'll find out maximum efficiency first by using this condition. So I need to differentiate an eta, that is equation number 1, with respect to I1, and I need to equate to 0. So I'll differentiate it and I'll equate it to 0. So while you're differentiating this, you have three terms. So I need to differentiate individually. So differentiation of 1 with respect to di1, that will be your first term. Second term, minus differentiation of with respect to I1, that is iron loss divided by V1 I1 cos phi 1, minus third term, differentiation of I1 R01 with respect to I1, I need to differentiate, divide by V1 cos phi 1. So I need to differentiate the eta equation with respect to I1 and I need to equate it to 0. So I will simplify this. So differentiation of 1 with respect to I1 will be 0 minus, now before differentiating this, I need to differentiate with respect to I1. So I1 term will remain inside, remaining terms will be constant. So iron loss V1 cos phi 1, everything will be constant. I will take it out, I will get iron loss divided by V1 cos phi 1 as constant, I will take it out. So inside differentiation, you will have only 1 divided by I1 minus, in the same way here, R01 V1 cos phi 1, everything is constant, I will take it out. So R01 divided by V1 cos phi 1, and inside differentiation, only I1 will remain, which is equal to 0. So now 0 minus iron loss divided by V1 cos phi 1. So differentiation of 1 by x, you know, minus 1 by x square. In the same way, differentiation of 1 by I1 with respect to I1 will be minus 1 divided by I1 square. Here minus R01 divided by V1 cos phi 1, which is constant, into differentiation of I1 with respect to I1 will be 1, which is equal to 0. Now I'll simplify this. So I'll get 0, just ignore it. So minus into minus will be plus. So iron loss divided by V1 I1 square cos phi 1, you'll get as first term, minus here R01 into 1 will be R01, write it as it is, V1 cos phi 1, which is equal to 0. Now I need to simplify this. I need to find out a condition for maximum efficiency. For maximum efficiency, I'm getting this equation. So if I simplify this, I will get some condition. So to simplify this, I will take this to right side. When I take this second term to right side, I will get as iron loss divided by V1 I1 square cos phi 1 is equal to, when this goes to right side, R01 divided by V1 cos phi 1. Now just simplify this, cos phi 1 gets cancelled, V1 gets cancelled. So only I1 square, which will remain in the left side, in the denominator, just cross multiply this. When you cross multiply, you will get iron loss, that is Wi, which will remain in the left side, which is equal to I1 square gets multiplied in the right side. So you'll get final equation as iron loss is equal to I1 square R01. So you know this is nothing but iron loss, which is equal to, what is I1 square R01? You can just see here, I1 square R01 is nothing but copper loss, which we had substituted earlier. So this is nothing but copper loss. So I can say that the condition for maximum efficiency is iron loss will be equal to copper loss. So this is what you have to derive under condition for maximum efficiency. So there is one more formula you need to remember in order to find out efficiency at any load and power factor, is given by this will be the formula used to find out the efficiency at any load and power factor. Here x is nothing but load. For full load, x will be equal to 1. For half load, x will be equal to 1 by 2. So this load will be given in the question while solving the problems. So kVA is nothing but rating of your transformer. kVA is nothing but rating, the power rating of the transformer, which will be given. And this is power factor. As you know, this is iron loss and copper loss. So this formula you need to remember. So to remember this, I will tell you how to remember this formula. You know, efficiency is nothing but output power divided by input power. So as I told, input is not always equal to output. It is equal to output plus losses. So if I substitute this in this formula, I will get output power divided by, in the place of input power, I will substitute this, output power plus losses. If I substitute this, output power, I know it is V2 I2 cos phi 2. So in the place of output power in the denominator, I will substitute once again V2 I2 cos phi 2 plus the losses. Now just compare this formula with the formula which you have written it will be almost same. We can just see VI, that is nothing but V into A. V is nothing but volt, A is ampere, that is the unit for voltage and current. So K, since we are going to write the rating of transformer in KVA, so since you are writing kilo, we need to multiply with 1000. That will be extra thing in numerator. And you can see into cos phi. Cos phi is nothing but power factor, that is what we have written. Divide by, in the denominator first comes VI cos phi, that is what once again I am writing KVA. This is the rating of transformer into, since I have written K kilo, I need to multiply with 1000 into cos phi is nothing but power factor. You can just compare these two equations plus losses. You have two types of losses under transformer, that is iron loss plus copper loss. So what is about X? So here we have included X in the numerator as well as denominator. X is nothing but load. So if you substitute X as 1 for full load, you can see these both equations will be same. Is it right? For load, when it changes, your equation will also change. So you need to multiply X on the numerator and denominator along with the output power. Then one more thing you can see, they have multiplied X square only for copper loss, not for iron loss, because iron loss is called as constant loss, copper loss is called as variable loss. So this is what you have to remember under the efficiency of a transformer.
Bible verse to meditate on.
Check out other videos in my channel regarding basic electrical and diploma mathematics 1. Please support this channel by subscribing to Joe Educare and click on the bell button to get the notification regarding new videos. Thank you. God bless you all. Bye.